In 1956, we started the Palestinian National Liberation Movement in the Gaza Strip. For 9 years, we were very secret. We met together. We talked together, always discussing the armed struggle. On January 1st, 1965, we launched our first operation into occupied Palestine, also called Israel. This was the first time that we faced the enemy. The people heard about us and wanted to join us. At first, we contacted the other Arab political parties and proposed the armed struggle. They not only rejected our ideas, but even tried to attack us, saying that the Palestinians can never liberate their land. They opposed the idea of a long people's war, claiming that the war must be short and decisive. Both the Israeli and the Arab governments sent their secret police to hunt down our commandos. Mass arrests were made, both inside Israel and the Arab countries. All the governments feared our revolution. We knew from the beginning that our war was not against the Jews. Our war was against the Zionist military machine that brutalized our people.
We are saying that Israel has taken our land by force, and there is no other way but by force to return to our land.
By September 1970, our revolution had gained much support among the Arab people. Jordan was our main base against Zionism. As the revolution grew stronger, the US government proposed that the United Nations adopt a special resolution, a so-called peaceful solution to the Middle East crisis. The US government began to send many arms to Hussein's regime in Jordan, not to fight Zionism, but to attack the revolution. The giant US corporations and banks have billions of dollars invested in the Arab countries. They would like to continue exploiting the resources that belong to the Arab people. That is why they are trying to crush the revolution. But the Palestinians have awakened the Arab people to fight US imperialism and its partners. Now we work underground in Jordan. From Syria and Lebanon, our operations continue against Israel. Inside the occupied territory, there are daily acts of resistance. Today, we are not alone. All over the world, in Vietnam, in Latin America, in Africa, people are fighting for their national liberation. Our fight will take many years, but we are determined to fight until victory.